Focus partners, dear attendants, thank you for joining us today and for the forthcoming 2 days events.
This is a short presentation of our municipality and of our project which is called Focus. The municipality of Agia is located in eastern Thessaly. Its population is 11,470 inhabitants as of 2011, and it covers a surface area of 668.26 square kilometers. International cooperation. This is a very important part for our municipality. The Municipality of Agia has signed a cooperation agreement with the Municipality of Ettenheim, Stadt Ettenheim, Baden-Württemberg, Germany. The cooperation agreement refers to the subjects waste management, water management, wastewater management, promotion of agricultural products and tourism. European Programs Office. The European Programs Office responsibility is to manage the projects of several EU programs like Europe for Citizens, Interreg, LIFE, Horizon 2020, COSME, Erasmus Plus, etc. So we are very happy to be here today for the organization of a Focus project, which is the first project that the Municipality of Agia is taking part as a leader and not only as a partner. The Focus project is financed by the Europe for Citizens program of the EU. It attempts to situate social economy into a broader political context through 4 distinct events. Investigates its relation with the well-known traditional theories and practices concerning the participation in the democratic life within Europe. And also it is a network of 10 partners that desire to disseminate as a best practice for the empowerment of civic participation of those citizens who have not been involved so far. Within this project, the Municipality of Agia coordinates the actions of a network of 10 European cities that explore new opportunities for political and democratic participation at national and EU level and wishes to communicate as good practice across Europe experiences on how social, intercultural and voluntary engagement and involvement of citizens, especially vulnerable social groups and social economy structures, associations, non-profit organizations and charitable institutions can increase their participation in the development of the EU.
I hope you know what is LEADER. And in Estonia we have 26 local action groups, and we, so I and Ede, coming from one named Western Harju Partnership. Each municipality we have 3 board members. It means one from municipality, one from non-governmental, and one from private sector. And in this time we have 16, so we have 2 vacancies to the board. So now I will talk this project, what its name is, Village of Hope. The Village of Hope established 15 years ago by the Bishop Matt Vahi and his son. They lived in Canada. Their parents moved to Canada in the last big war, and now they came back and they wanted to give for Estonians something good, and they started this non-governmental organizations which operates in public interest and with the aim to help the socially underprivileged and delinquent people. What what is the Village of Hope? The rehabilitation program does not make the Village of Hope a detention camp. On the contrary, the people have joined because their own free will to make changes in their lives. One of the partners of the timber industry said, "I'm astonished that you don't keep your tools and other things under lock and key. They do even this so-called regular establishments. You really manage to change the people's attitude to society, development, and the first and the foremost to themselves."
After many years of participation and interaction in loads of European programs, we are extremely happy to be the leaders of this project and host it in our territory. Sure, at the end of the program, we will have new friends and partners for the rest of our lives. My colleagues in the European Programs Bureau, the next 4 days, that will be interesting, having not only speeches and workshops, but also visits to our region.
Τόσο οι κοινωνικές επιχειρήσεις, όσο και η κοινωνική οικονομία, παρά το γεγονός ότι για την Ευρώπη και την Αμερική αποτελούν επιτυχημένες πρακτικές εδώ και πολλές δεκαετίες, εδώ στην Ελλάδα εξακολουθούν να προκαλούν σύγχυση, ερωτηματικά και απορίες σε πολλούς.
Both social businesses and the social economy, despite the fact that for Europe and the US have been successful practices for decades, here in Greece, they continue to cause confusion, doubts and questions to many.
Σε παγκόσμιο επίπεδο, η ανάπτυξη της κοινωνικής οικονομίας αποτελεί μια πραγματικότητα με εκπληκτικές διαστάσεις.
Globally, the development of the social economy is a reality with amazing dimensions.
Τα πεδία δραστηριότητας που αναπτύσσονται αφορούν κυρίως στον πολιτισμό, στην εκπαίδευση, στην έρευνα, στην υγεία, στην κοινωνική φροντίδα, στο περιβάλλον, στην υπεράσπιση των ανθρωπίνων δικαιωμάτων, στη φιλανθρωπία, στη διεθνή ανθρωπιστική και αναπτυξιακή βοήθεια.
The areas of activity that are developing, relate mainly to culture, education, research, health, social care, the environment, the defense of human rights, philanthropy and international humanitarian and development aid.
Η περιφέρεια Θεσσαλίας, ιδίως στα χρόνια της κρίσης, όπου όλοι αναζητούν τη διέξοδο αυτή, έχει ενεργό ρόλο όχι μόνο στη στήριξη τέτοιων πρωτοβουλειών μέσω των κοινωνικών ταμείων που διαχειρίζεται, αλλά και με τη συμμετοχή της σε ευρωπαϊκά προγράμματα, μέσω των οποίων έχει τη δυνατότητα να μελετήσει καλές πρακτικές και πολιτικές από την Ευρωπαϊκή Ένωση, ώστε μετά να μεταλαμβάνει τη γνώση αυτή στους τοπικούς φορείς.
The region of Thessaly, particularly during the years of crisis, where everyone is looking for a way out of it, plays an active role not only in supporting such initiatives through the community funds that it manages, but also by participating in European programs through which there is the ability to study good practices and policies of the EU and then pass this knowledge on to local authorities.
Ενδεικτικά θα ήθελα να αναφερθώ σε μερικά από αυτά τα προγράμματα, καθώς και την προστιθέμενη αξία για το τόπο μας.
Indicatively, I would like to mention some of these programs and their added value to our country.
Responsible Med, πρόγραμμα διαπεριφερειακής συνεργασίας Med. Το πρόγραμμα αυτό αναπτύχθηκε σε ένα διεθνές πλαίσιο που συνδέει όλο και περισσότερο την εταιρική κοινωνική ευθύνη με την ανταγωνιστικότητα. Στην Ευρωπαϊκή Ένωση, η εταιρική κοινωνική ευθύνη θεωρείται μέρος ζωτικής σημασίας στην πρόοδο του επιχειρηματικού πνεύματος. Αξιολογεί τη σύνδεση μεταξύ της εταιρικής κοινωνικής ευθύνης και των επιπέδων καινοτομίας και την ανταγωνιστικότητα στο ΜΕΤ μεσογειακό χώρο. Το πρόγραμμα συνδέεται με το θέμα της εταιρικής κοινωνικής ευθύνης ως πιθανό εργαλείο για την καινοτομία και την ανταγωνιστικότητα στη μεσογειακή περιοχή.
Responsible Med, Med Interregional Cooperation Program. It was developed in an international framework that continuously links corporate social responsibility and competitiveness. In the EU, corporate social responsibility is considered of vital importance to the promotion of entrepreneurship. It evaluates the connection between corporate social responsibility and the level of innovation and competitiveness in the Mediterranean area, MD. The program is linked to the issue of corporate social responsibility as a possible tool for innovation and competitiveness in the Mediterranean region.
So, firstly, just to provide you a short feedback about my profile, I'm a research associate and external expert in the University of Thessaly. I'm responsible for the Career Services Office. As you can see, I was working as European project manager in a various fields in the university. From recently, I was authorized to lead, to become the head of the vocational training center. And so also I'm working as the person in charge for providing the support for all the staff and the faculty that are expressing their interest to submit a successful application at the Erasmus Plus project. And recently also I have been asked from the European Commission to become an expert evaluator for Horizon projects. So what I'm going to do today is to provide you a brief profile of what we are implementing during these years. Some projects initiative and also the profile of the Career Service Office, which are all of them are really very close to the project profile and objectives of your focus project. The objective of the Career Service Office is to try to provide a permanent link between the graduates and the business world. All our graduates, just before they complete their studies, they visit us in order to be able to provide them a set of services that most of their services have to do with their transmission to the labor market. What makes the Career Service Office unique, not only in Greece and also in Europe, because I had the chance to travel a lot, meet a lot of partners across Europe, and they told me that their career office, they just provide some traditional service and they are not so active in terms of project, is this, that were actively involved in many project initiatives of these years. This is the famous, I guess most of you are very familiar and close to this project, is the Erasmus for Young Entrepreneurs. It's, I think at the moment it's the most popular project in terms of entrepreneurship. And what is its philosophy? Try to provide mobility opportunity for nascent entrepreneurs, new entrepreneurs, wannabe entrepreneurs, that they have the ability to travel to host entrepreneurs for 1 month until 6 months. So there are a lot of benefits, not only for the new entrepreneur that has the opportunity to travel abroad, but also for the host entrepreneur. Because the host entrepreneur is hosting a new person from a different country and he can exchange ideas to build some fruitful cooperation. This is a very short promo video that we prepared until the time that the navigation game will be ready. So, as you will see, there's a navigator and he's going to walk around the virtual city and try to find information. And the user has the opportunity to answer the various questions, and according to his performance, he takes some final results, how he's going to improve his entrepreneurship skills.
Opportunities and perspectives, difficulties and problems of the participation of local authorities and networks, European programs and projects. There are opportunities and prospects for the Greek cities. There is access to specialist expertise on developing integrating and participatory action plans, access to good practices on issues of common interest, exchange of experience in addressing common problems, and understanding of the decision-making and planning of the financial tools on European level. Some difficulties and problems for the Greek cities when participating in European networking internal difficulties are incoming perceptions and lack of interest on the part of the elected administration, lack of expertise and inadequate staffing, deficiencies in infrastructure and equipment, procurement procedures for the procurement of goods and contracting of services, control of expenditure, recruitment process and expenditure certification. It is a development agency of the Prefecture of Larissa, established in June 1992, following a decision of the main social partners of the area in response to the need of management and implementation of the leader program for the Elassona area. The shareholders are local authorities, bodies and association of the regional unit of Larissa. The objectives of INO are information services to local actors for development initiatives and provision of technical support for the submission of investment proposal and funding programs, collection and documentation of data about the state of the art and development trends in the region, EU funding opportunities focused to developmental programs for less developed and less favored areas. Business studies, marketing and management studies for the support of new and existing enterprises. Vocational training and educational activities of programs funded by the European Social Fund. Publicity and informational activities, Infodays, conferences, networking, etc.
Organizations in the area, so the public sector or the municipalities, the private sector entrepreneurs, and NGOs. And so our action group has 85 members. We have 6 municipalities and around 40 entrepreneurs and around 40 NGOs. The aim is to bring them together so that they would exchange their knowledge and opinions and work together and have projects together.
Social entrepreneurship is such activity that transforms social capital in a way that affects society positively. And it is said, not my words, but Wikipedia was the smart one this time, that social entrepreneurs recognize immediate social problems but also seek to understand the broader context. So one example is Rasi, who worked a short supply chain. This is a local NGO. It brings together local small producers and local consumers. And the mission is to make the journey from producer to consumer as short as possible. So they have a market day once a week. It lasts only 1 hour. People can order beforehand from the local farmer to find out this. And then they meet with the farmer, and there's always something that you can buy without ordering. So why, in our local action group, we enhance social entrepreneurship? Why do we support it? As you already saw from the examples, to respond more effectively to other public needs and rising expectations. As we see every day, this one-size-fits-all approach is outdated, but always needs change. And it's much faster if people themselves come together, do something, instead of waiting, well, maybe the municipality would do something, maybe the government could do something. It's much faster and easier to do it yourself.
But today, I'm not going to focus only on this project that was invited, but on the architecture of social entrepreneurship in Porto, from where this project is part of. Because I feel I have the opportunity here to present you something that I like to present the whole story in Porto. This is the project that I am most actively involved with. and it kind of gathers all these previous projects and more, because this it's Cidade Mais. This is my organization, the Raiz, which means from the roots. And Cidade Mais, it's an event, a four-day event in July in Porto. And the goal of this event is to bring together the municipalities, corporations, the citizen, social movements and universities. So we try to design initiatives that put all these crowds together, working very close.
So the association has set ambitious goals. First is developing the awareness of the population about heritage, then training young people in trades that are associated with the tradition, training local population for specializing in renewable energy, restoring old houses, reviving local gastronomy, and developing cultural and sustainable tourism. Here are some of the activities, like development of cultural tourism and showing local people the opportunities that cultural tourism has for the economic development, organizing and participating in promotional activities, preparing educational projects like Young Gardens of Heritage, which is educating young people, young tourist guides and animators of heritage, and preparing other projects where young people are learning about the old crafts, especially building of dry stone walls.
We are utility cooperative. It's a cooperative of collective interest, so it's like an NGO, but in a cooperative form. We are 70 members in the cooperative. We have public authorities, private bodies and individuals. And we have an association of 70 members as well in the cooperative, so it makes 140 bodies. The aim is to promote renewable energies, energy savings and sustainable developments. So it's we do waste management plans, urbanism plans, carbon balances, sustainable development plans such as Agenda 21. So it's an expert pool that helps the territories toward sustainable development. And the last one, the last part, is the innovation lab. That's my job. I'm responsible for the innovation lab, which aim is when you come to the innovation lab when you have an innovative project or when you want to do something new on the territory, and we help you to create the ecosystem in the territory for your innovation to take off. So there's a lot of different activities. It can be activities from a European partner that want to do something with us. So this is the idea to dynamize the territory.
Démarré du Cotentin et du Bessin, accueille l'une des concentrations de bâtis en terre parmi les plus remarquables de France. Ces bâtiments, aujourd'hui anciens, parfois de plusieurs siècles, doivent être entretenus et restaurés de manière adaptée, sous peine de se dégrader et de perdre leurs propriétés naturelles de régulation hydroélectrique.
Depuis longtemps, le parc mène une politique en faveur de la rénovation des maisons en terre, qui sont le patrimoine remarquable de la région des Marais. On a fait le constat que ces aides laissent de côté les gens qui ont peu de revenus. On a essayé d'imaginer un dispositif expérimental alternatif qui permette de réaliser des travaux avec peu de moyens.
C'est dans ce contexte qu'est né le dispositif Enerter. Son principe est basé sur la réciprocité. Il s'agit d'aider les habitants à restaurer eux-mêmes leur maison en faisant appel à d'autres particuliers, eux aussi en attente de travaux, qui recevront en retour l'aide de ceux qu'ils ont aidés. Les chantiers sont encadrés par un professionnel du bâtiment et un animateur du dispositif se charge de coordonner les travaux et de mobiliser les participants.
Okay. For the cooperation that we do in our place, we've got the Solidarity Café, who support the...
which are the tracks for future projects. We do our people interested. So, NRTR for Greeks and Refugees, the project of Olivier. And in SFO, we are quite interested in mixing digital transition and energy transition. That is, with internet, we have a very powerful tool, but we don't have an objective for this tool. It can be used for whatever we want. Those associations hosting volunteers are in our region about 3,000. And of course, they are engaged in many different activities. Most of them are running social assistance activities, like taking care of migrants and refugees, or disabled elderly people that are living alone, and so on. Some other organizations are working in the environmental protection or in the promotion of culture, many different activities.
My organization is Forum Terzo Settore Lazio. Is a non-profit organization. Currently is a form of 29 regional first sector network that operate in various fields: education, culture, mental illness, disability, international cooperation, green economy, social agriculture, and ICT, and so on. Forum Terzo Settore Lazio is an organization of social and political representation and participation which promotes the interests and value of volunteering, social cooperation, the association, NGOs, and others in Rome and throughout the Lazio region in central Italy.
From ICA, this non-profit association founded in 1995 by families of those with mental illness because of the vulnerability of the social group and the absence of intermediate and rehabilitation resources in the friends of the diversity. It struck me that, like a counseling body, very indicative for social awareness with defending persons with mental illness and their families. 5 years later, there's an error. 5 years later, we started to manage services with economic cooperation of public administration and private entities, always to improve their life quality.
I work in a study. I am administrative finance director. I work in social area since 1993.
Maestad, casa vieja. Y Valdearroces, en Valdearroces, tienen tantos centros para acercar sus servicios a todos los usuarios de la poco poblada pero extensa provincia de Valdearroces y cuenta con una flota de 25 vehículos repartidos según las necesidades de los centros. Y ahora mismo están ya por los... ¿Sigue? Suma... ¿Más? ¿Un poco más? Ahí. 124 trabajadores repartidos por los centros de día incubacionales, centros especiales de empleo y residencias de la provincia, como los coches, que hacen un total de 1.833 kilómetros al día y 421.590 en todo el año para llegar a prestar todos sus servicios a los más de 260 usuarios de Agia, conectando toda la provincia.
What is really a social entrepreneur? A social entrepreneur is somebody that is by definition an innovator. Now, why is that? Because a social entrepreneur identifies where the society and the community is stuck and cannot move further. It's in a crisis, but in a specific issue. It can be a very big issue, it can be a very small issue. The second thing a social entrepreneur does, after identifying where the problem is and the society is stuck, is then design a solution. Design a solution that will unstuck the society in that specific area. In order, though, to design that solution, That doesn't just make you a social entrepreneur. We know very many that design lots of things and lots of solutions, but they fail in their application. So the third thing that a social entrepreneur needs to do is to make it applicable and prove that its application and implementation works. So the fourth element is to prove that it works. So you have to make sure that it works. And then you have to prove that it works. And then the fifth point, the most difficult point, is to convince everybody in the society that this is the solution for the problem of the society. Because if you do not convince that everybody has a benefit out of that solution, then your social entrepreneurial solution is not really something that is having roots.
I think that we need to clarify three things. Think number one, do we know what we are talking about? What's the content of this entrepreneurship, of this enterprise? What exactly are we going to do? Okay? To identify, not just, you know, services or service delivery, or I'm here to help you or to assist you if you need something. You know, it's quite vague. We cannot get the benefits of social entrepreneurship if we're thinking like that. So the second thing is, what kind of structure do we need for that? To identify the structures that we need. Because if we get back to the state structure, then it is a very stable situation, and the structures there are quite similar the last 150 years, and nothing changed there. But here, we are in a situation that we can identify what kind of structure do we need. A hierarchical, for example, structure. Do we need a more network style of structure? Do we need a more collective structure? What exactly do we need to optimize, to maximize the outcome of the content that we have identified in the previous step? And the third and last thing, but for me it's most important, is what kind of regulation do we need for that? Who regulates there? Who puts the rules?
First of all, I would like to thank you for the invitation, especially I would like to thank the mayor of Agia. Social economy is something that concerns all of us, not only the business world. Everybody can be a consumer and invest in it. And for the first time in Greece, there will be a convention in Athens about economy. There is a historical necessity to deal with the problem. There has been a degenerating course of the wages due to technical advances. The solution is that the citizens themselves become their own bosses. In Greece, there are two economies, an official one and a realistic one. The official one exists more in theory, because the resources that are available for an investment in this sector go towards other goals and are mostly absorbed by the government. Attention must be paid to agriculture and to health. There must be knowledge of technical in general. There must be a creative interaction between citizen organization and local authorities. In order to create a suitable environment in the form of social local actions.
Agia municipality. It is part of Algeria. Me and my colleague, Irina Zhegova. Let's start. Social services is specialized institution in Estonian municipality is the theme.
For providing of social services were designed and implemented for program development and maintenance of the basic life skills, program supported socialization and individual and group work activities. Sheltered housing provides, including receiving and stimulating development environment for people with special needs, comfort and convenience.
And we'll be explaining about best practices in developing social entrepreneurship. However, we will be splitting this presentation about who we are. We'll be showing you a tour, so you will get to know about Nashar. We'll be speaking about organizations in the locality and how do organizations collaborate.
They need not only resources about funds, but they need input from the central government, input from the inhabitants within the localities, and obviously human resources to work for the benefit of our inhabitants and localities. So what we consider in our locality as the social economy organizations, as Paul said, our island has been influenced by other countries that have been through the years on our island. So church authorities and commissions, band clubs, which play a significant role in our country, scouts, for instance, for the kids, and even for aged people, football and sports clubs, other charitable organizations which are different on our islands within each locality.
We are a social enterprise active in the field of culture, education and tourism. We were established in 2014 in the area in the city of Larissa. We created to support social and cultural integration, cross-cultural dialogue, non-formal artistic, entrepreneurial, environmental and civic education. Our activities are focused on educational, pedagogical and interventions, artistic shows and performances, promotional and participatory athletic and festival activities events, awareness raising campaigns and special actions for the protection of cultural heritage, environmental and traditional products, and the organization of alternative tourism packages.
I would like to say that I feel very lucky that you are here with us, that we will have the opportunity to continue our cooperation. Believe me, there is always here for you an open door and an open place to work with, and of course to come whenever you want. This is something that is a part of the Greek mentality. If we are the hosts, the guests are part of our house. So thank you very much, and I strongly believe that we will keep working together and making effort for a best future.